guys, Brian here. Just coming at you with a video. Just doing a little bit of an update on my discus tank. Couple of things that have changed or whatever. I've done a little bit of rescaping. I'll get into that in a minute. But check out this, my albino cobalt that's hanging out down in the corner here. He's been acting really weird for the last 2 days. He'll kind of hide and hang out all by himself. He used to be the second most dominant fish in the tank. But when I go to feed him, he perks right up, comes up. You know, he'll eat beef heart out of forceps or sometimes my fingers. I'll do a feeding right now real quick with some black worms, and you'll see him. He'll come right up and he's eating. He perks right up, so I'm not quite sure. See, there he goes. But anyway, here's a quick black worm feeding for you guys. You guys just love that stuff. Feeding them black worms, frozen blood worms, and frozen beef heart. Zoom in a little bit here. Did some slight rescaping too. I moved the driftwood piece a little bit further over to the left. Still thinking I'm going to bring it over a little bit more. Got a few more plants in and moved a few things around. You can see in the back there I got a big clump of, around here all the LFSs call it water lettuce, but wisteria, water wisteria. Next to that there's a big val with some real long leaves that come all the way out to the front of the tank. You can see them hanging down there. Got another piece of jungle val back in the corner there, not quite as big. Another small piece of wisteria. Three nice chunks of dwarf sage right here to replace the ones I had gotten some nice pieces from Big Z. In that contest he had, and my Pleco just tore them all up. These seem to be doing good so far. You saw a video I did on the broadleaf sage that I have along the side there. That seems to be doing good. A lot of it's melted and I trimmed it up. What else? I guess that's about it. Oh, I got these two onion plants too. I don't know the actual scientific name on those, but you can see them there. They got the little bulb that looks like an onion, and kind of cool, something different. Moved one of the swords, this sword over here, moved it over a little bit to the left and brought it up a little closer to the front. Sorry about that, that's my work phone. And then I got a few more snails. Ooh, the mystery snail's out right now on the rock there. He's actually moving around. Thing's really cool. Having fun watching him. And a couple of tiger snails that I haven't been able to find since last night. It was the last time I saw them, but whatever. You know, things are looking a little scraggly in here, but I'm being patient. Oh, this melon sword that I thought I pretty much had lost. I kept the, whatever you call it, the rhizome, I guess. And I put it, there's a hole in this piece of driftwood. I put it in the hole, and I'm starting to see some growth. There's a little bit of dead leaf on there, but there's some new growth coming out there, so that's cool. And then, there's one other thing. But anyway, that's all I got for the tank right now. I just noticed today, too, that I've hit 499 subscribers, so I'm right around the corner from 500, so I want to thank everybody who subscribes to me and watches my videos. That's awesome. Oh, and a couple other things that I've done. On my YouTube channel, I put some playlists together. I don't know if anybody's noticed that or looked at them, but I put together one that's kind of got most of my tank videos from since I started on YouTube, so you can kind of go back and see how things have progressed. I did Africans one other time before, unsuccessfully, in a little 30-gallon tank. There's a few videos of those on there. And then you see where my 125 is now. There used to be a 55-gallon there and some South American cichlids. And it's just kind of neat to kind of go along and see, you know, what I've done along the way. At least it was for me. I don't know. It might not be interesting to you guys, but kind of fun to watch how it's progressed over here at my place and what I've done. I also put together a playlist of just the Discus Tank and the videos I've shot on that, kind of from start to finish. A lot of people were interested in that when I was kind of setting up the tank and everything. And then another thing, we've had a lot of activity. Some of us are on Instagram lately, and it's been kind of fun. Big Munoz 11, he got me started on Instagram. Well, not started, I was already on it, but I wasn't really doing much, but he told me that he was on there, and I started following him, and we had a lot of fun. And then soon after that, Rizzo got in touch with me on there too. And then just recently, Mr. Honey to You joined up, and he's joining the party. There's some other people from the YouTube community on there. I know Dallas or Zero Dallas, he's on there too. I forget what his name is on there, but Rizzo, if you guys want to follow him, it's RIZZO1_2. Big Munoz 11, I think I'm trying to find him. I got my phone here. I think on Instagram, he's just Big Munoz. I can't remember what Dallas is. Mr. Honey to You, I believe, is Mr. H to You. I can't find him right now. Sorry, I should have prepared more for this. But anyway, some of these guys are on there. There's some other people that I don't know if they're on YouTube, but they put out really cool pictures on Instagram. And oh, and I'm Dolly VH on there, by the way. And I put the link on my YouTube homepage too. But yeah, check it out. If you guys are into taking photos of your fish and you're on Instagram, come follow all of us. We're having a good time over there too. So, other than that, I think that's about it right now, guys. Thanks for following me. I'll be getting a update video on some of my other tanks coming up soon. A few people have asked to see how those things are going. Since I'm in the same room, I'll just give you a quick look at the Severum tank. Bad reflection there, but there's the red. There's my Yaru, however you want to pronounce it. I lost my big green Severum that had Popeye. I don't know if I did an update on that since I shot the video where he had the Popeye. Next morning he was gone. But anyway, thanks guys for watching, and later.